just stick with it.
Whoa, that's so beautiful.
I feel so nice to be here.
I know, right? After what happened. Oh.
Mindo the guy up in security. Let us jingle one.
Wow. That's how you do it.
Ansamboy, mtakuwa kunywa?
As always, brother.
What do you want?
Sometimes the best treasures are hidden in plain sight, tucked away on distant shores, whispering tales of beauty and tranquility for those willing to listen. Our adventure whisked us to the serene Congo River Island, a secret artery of life threading through the heart of nature itself. A surprise of seafood delicacies, fresh catches of the day transformed into culinary masterpieces savored under the shade of palm fronds. This journey promises not just a glimpse, but an immersive exploration of the wonders that Wasini Island has to offer, leaving you with indelible memories of this captivating marine paradise. The highlight of Wasini was the beautiful dolphin swimming alongside our bow, and the lifestyle photoshoot we did on board the wooden boat. Experience the enchantment, watch this video till the end, like, share and subscribe for more breathtaking journeys similar to this one.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
It's a new day.
By the way, it's only for a few people, and you're not one of them.
Mindo kama gera eh? Gari meja dere twende. Sheria ko mbele. Yes ndo kona map.
Sheria unaka mbele?
Eh. African.
Do the thing see.
Utamwambia
I wanted to find someone who is in front. All
right.
Thank you babe.
Mbio ndio tutoke. Harakisheni ndio tuende tunachelewa.
Pesa hapo nyuma wewe hiyo ya. Change tunachukua kesho eh.
Video.
Thank you. unaweza kuniadapt. Ona na hiyo kofia. Ona tu vile anaka. Muone. Muone.
Ndio imemshtua.
Oh my god. Sisi tulishafika, wengine wetu wameamua kulala, but sisi kaguu na njia.
Hapo kuna maji hapo hivi.
Tutalala Nairobi tukirudi. Hivi ndio tunatembeanga Mombasa. We're going to have some food and shop and then come back.
No, hit the beach kidogo.
Hit the beach, eh? Kwanza hapo bidibadu tunaweza pitia tukunywe ka one for the road. Badal.
Jambo jambo. Mimi ndio Moha mwenyewe nilikuwa mkiongea naye kwa simu.
Ah, vipi Moha?
Mimi kwa
sasa. Ah,
hii ni plot yangu, nimetoka kwa ofisi nimekuja hapa kwa plot yangu sasa.
Ah, poa kabisa man.
Nashukuru.
Mm-hmm.
Mimi nitawapeleka Wasini na mta enjoy hiyo tu, acha nionyeshe tu mapicha. Hapo ndio ndio restaurant mtakula.
That's the Wasini Island.
Sasa hiyo ni poa. Lakini
Oh,
nice. And catchment. Eating lunch at facing the sea level.
Hey, ni Saturday.
Saturday.
Sitakuwa na wewe?
Kesho.
Eh.
Kwani mnaenda nyumbani lini?
Sunday.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wasini tumiko tumepanga tukuje Saturday.
Saturday? Na mmejua rates zangu.
Ah, basi si wewe tuliongea naye kaa tu kufika hapo basi si wewe. Sasa mimi mwenye niliongea naye tulifika huko kote. Tuli discuss kila kitu, hata anajua vile atatupujia na atatupeleka.
Na aliwapata kwa bei ngapi?
1500.
Yeah. You have got your own transport.
Eh?
Huh? Hapana, anatukujia pia.
Na 1500.
Yeah. Yeah.
Per person.
Per person.
Okay.
Hapana nini?
Sijui kama anaweza wapeleka kweli. Kazi hiyo, hata mtu akiwa na own transport huwa ni 2000. Akiwa na own transport.
2000.
Lakini mimi package yangu, drinks to and fro, kila kitu ni 3K.
Drinks gani hizo?
Drinks gani, utapata zaka cocktail.
Amesema means to and fro.
Kwa hivyo nimeongea na mwenzenu wenu, kwa simu na James pale.
Hivi ndio tulikaa. Tulikuja
James ni yupi yule akoko ndani?
Yule akoko ndani.
Oh.
Na mimi magari zangu ni nzuri, nawapatia transport to and fro kwa boat, pia mtapata drinks.
Pia 2000.
Eh?
Pia 2000.
Watu.
Unataka kujifunga mshipi ya nini?
Una seat belt?
Ndio hiyo. Kwa hiyo umeka hiyo kwa
vya hiyo. Hebu chukua namba nini? Kuna chachisha.
Sikuenda mlibadu ya netu.
Achilia kwa jilekio. Paka yiko na seat belt. Shere
chukua namba. Yo neti kenda shere. Nyana kuleka.
Kuleka.
Ano utatoshea lesa kujua wawili.
Wow.
Mama yenu.
Kupenye mesuamu. Alafu nena.
Ula slave kitulia.
Lakini ni comfortable.
Sana.
Gani hiyo.
Kato. Kata mkono sindio? Bani?
Kata mkono.
Nona hiyo ata inako. Airushirushi mtu kama zile tuktuk za kitambo.
Sawa. Mbaka lusha leo. Sawa.
Naseo mekula kakuku yani.
Jesu!
Uwe, hapa ni Diani boss. Kwa Diani,
ya? Hini barabara Diani, wako ni barabara.
Hini barabara
Diani. Uwe, hini Diani. Ja, chukwe hivi.
Chukwa kila mse, chukwa ndi sheriu.
Iye, sani, iye, labda chukwa chi.
Vipi loka?
Make sure umecapture face yake.
Make sure uwe shikini kanda mkono hii.
Capture them, kanda mkono.
Ndio lazima yeye anza hapo. Umesha make sure nyote mmeonekana kitubia.
Mkana mkono, mkana mkono, mkana mkono.
Hiyo tuktuk ni comfortable.
Hebu ndio. Hata mimi ameya tukwe.
Hapa ni ndani ya tuktuk niko na warembo watatu.
Wewe si mrembo.
Wewe si mrembo, si ni Ruth, Ruth Lexi na Sherry. Wewe si kwesabu. Wewe ni others.
Eh, unga si wewe.
Ada. Eh, Ruthy.
Yes.
Sasa pige ka smile kiasi hapo eh.
Sasa ndio anything.
Sasa ameshiba kwa fiti.
Bwana wago. Hey, ako hivi. Ube mama.
Hello Gamin. Sio ndugu yako hapo. Oh, nimeget. Kuna magnification. Yesu.
Sana
record kucha za watu.
My culinary experiences have revolved around the basic tilapia and omena, also known as silver cyprinine in English. These traditional dishes have been deeply rooted in the Kenyan culture, reflecting the rich culinary heritage of my country. However, today presented me with a unique opportunity to venture beyond the familiar and delve into the world of seafood cuisine, commonly found in five-star hotels across major cities worldwide. Before we embark on this gastronomical adventure, let me share an exciting highlight from the previous night at our rented beach house, where I witnessed some wild scenes by the pool, immersing myself further in the vibrant Kenyan culture. Join me as we discover mouth-watering flavors and cultural fusion that awaits us.
Okay, yeah. Any settings too?
Okay.
There was something you were to record.
Yeah.
So how comes it's reddish?
Because of the lighting over here.
Oh, yeah.
When we move here, you see it changes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yo, guys, eh? Dive.
Go diving, baby.
Come see me diving.
Be careful, yo. Juu ya maji imekuchapa kwa tumbo, sio?
Yeah, imenichapa slightly. Hapa juu ya tumbo.
Yeah, you can dive here. Sunge dive ile side nyingine nyingine na huko.
Naona ni kwa shallow. Hapo ni safi. Hizo stairs.
Size yake.
You guys are not aware of the stairs.
Yeah, go out and dive from the side.
Good morning.
Cameraman. Take a dive.
We are doing our makeup before going to have seafood because we plan to do a mini photo shoot at the beach while the seafood is being prepared.
Tungoje woka tujue kama beba kamera zote.
Okay. Hacha geukage.
Kuna pande yani imetiwa hiyo.
Because
we've been oppressed so long, we feel like we have a right to.
Wow.
Yes, you have a right to.
You can catch a kick.
So you're a tourist? Like a tourist.
As not gonna be I'm African.
Nani? Oh. What about you?
I don't want to go.
Welcome to Cooperative Bank. Contact.
Hey.
Please wait while we transfer your call to the available name.
River Congo is not only a beautiful spot, but also a popular tourist destination for its delicious seafood cuisine and majestic views of the ocean. It is the perfect place to enjoy a meal while taking in the stunning scenery. However, due to its seasonal nature, it is important to time your visit accordingly to fully enjoy the river's beauty. It is recommended to visit the location very early in the morning.
Are you capturing
The river is surrounded by lush greenery and has a serene atmosphere, making it an ideal spot for relaxation. Moreover, it is a great location for water activities such as swimming and kayaking. Visitors can also enjoy a variety of seafood dishes, including freshly caught crab, prawns, and fish, which are prepared by local chefs. The seafood is usually served with rice, cassava, or an accompaniment of your choice. While planning a trip to River Congo, it is advisable to check the weather forecast and tide schedules to ensure that the river is not completely dry. With its stunning views, delicious seafood, and relaxing atmosphere, River Congo is a must-visit destination for anyone looking to experience the beauty of Diani Beach.
Hapa tuko na naona shrimps, prawns kwa wingi. Samaki, octopus, nyingine tuko na.
The mini photoshoot we did at River Congo turned out to be a lot of fun. As we waited for our seafood cuisine to be prepared, we took advantage of the beautiful location and did a quick beach photoshoot. The stunning scenery provided the perfect backdrop for our photos, and we captured some amazing shots. It was a great way to pass the time while we waited for our food, and the photos turned out to be a great memory of our experience at River Congo.
Octopus.
Just imagine doing a photo shoot at the deepest part of the ocean while on a moving wooden boat. Think about that for a second, guys. To give you context, this photo shoot happened in the middle of a short film, particularly the boat scene. And the idea behind the photo shoot was that the photos we are going to create from this particular scene are going to be used as a cover for the short film. This short film had many scenes, and this particular boat scene was ideal to create amazing cover photos. While watching the video, you'll get to experience African culture, specifically Swahili culture here at the Kenyan coastline, and you're also going to experience marine life at the Kisite Mpunguti National Marine Park. And this is a unique video. I've not seen something like this on YouTube, and I can assure you this video is going to entertain you. You're going to learn one or two things about the African culture, specifically Kenyan culture, to be more specific, the Swahili. And while you're doing that, you're going to experience and enjoy amazing photos that you're going to create on this specific trip. Let me highlight quickly the gear I used to film this video. I was shooting on the Nikon Z6 Mark II. And of course, the other crew members had accompanying cameras. I had a drone, which we were not able to use because we needed a permit and it's a long process. I also had this audio recorder, which is the Zoom H6 hand recorder. And also, this is the DRS Mic 2 shotgun mic. I used the Nikon D850 to create the amazing portraits. And since we were on a boat, we needed a wider perspective. So we were using a 35mm, and also we were using mainly a 50mm. Actually, both cameras, the Nikon Z6 Mark II and the Nikon D850, they both had a 50mm prime lens. We were all using natural light, so we didn't carry lighting.
Maybe in jail.
Okay, on our way to home.
You forget you're f***ing hot. Yeah, Montana. Yeah, Montana. kati ya cups tumeacha kwa ile match. We gonna tumble ama mlibeba. Ana kama nazo.
Welcome on board.
My name.
Our boat's name is MV Angel. MV stands for Marine Vessel. And Angel, the name of the boat. So I would like to introduce you to the members on board. He's Mbaruk, our captain.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He's assisting Mbaruk Safwan.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
He is Hamisi.
Jambo.
Omar. Jambo, everybody.
Hello, my fingers.
Our finger. So on board, we have the box in front. That's a changing room. In case you want to do changing, you go down to the box. Snorkeling starts from the boat. So we have a ladder to take us up and down. For the non-swimmer, we can assist them. The snorkeling instructor in here, who are going to assist everybody in snorkeling, for those who they don't trust themselves. We have the rings. The rings will work as a water taxi. It will help in snorkeling. And we have some swim vest too. If you don't trust yourself, know that you're in safety hands with us. You can and we can. So from where we started, the trip will take an hour to Kisite Marine National Park. And the park is situated behind the island. In front of us, that's Wasini Island. Wasini covers 7 kilometer length and 2.5 kilometer width. On the other side, Wasini, it's very narrow. It's why you see the buildings are just along the shore. It's half kilometer, the rest of the kilometer is covered by mangrove forest. As we have seen the dolphin, but we still give you a chance. Maybe on the way to the park, we might see some other group. If we are lucky, we are going to give you enough time for that too, till we are going to arrive in Kisite Marine National Park, and there it's where we are going to stop for snorkeling. Snorkeling is to use the mask and tube. We go into the sea, viewing the corals and fish while we are in the sea, not on the boat. After all, we are all satisfied in that, we will drive back slowly towards that village over there, and there it's where we're going to have our yum yum. Sometimes we are using the other way around to go to the park, and coming back, we use the other way around. So we will keep a round figure. What we serve for lunch, it's seafood lunch, which means fish, alternative of chicken, or vegetarian. That is what is included. What costs extra? Lobster costs extra, calamari costs extra, octopus cost extra, prawns cost extra. And platter cost extra. Platter, it's a combination of all seafood that form platter. After lunch is an afternoon program, which is to visit the village.
Vini.
Namtoi.
Have one.
Mimi ni fish. Ni wewe nilikuwa naitia. Nataka tu supu sasa. Serving after you. Crab. Samaki hapa.
Crab is here, yeah.
Samaki hapa.
Crab, nani alitisha crab?
Crab is in the menu. Oh. Sorted meat is a crab. If you have it,
it's in your menu. Where's the cooler fish? The cooler fish.
Sushi itisha sasa.
Apa bro?
Tinggal.
Ayo kasava. Sini kalau tu lihat orang matan.
Deep.
Anyway, new to Aje.
You have seen, you all have a lovely day with us, didn't you?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, be our big ambassadors when you drive back to hotel, when you fly back to respective home, when you drive back home, speak good about our place. And we are not hesitating to welcome you back to Wasini Island for more doubt trips.
Amen.
Otherwise, we say enjoy the rest of your holiday in Kenya until you fly back home safely. And those who are driving back home, they drive back home safely.
Thank you so much for watching this video from start to finish. I really appreciate. I would highly recommend that you subscribe to this YouTube channel because I have amazing videos coming up, a series of similar videos that I'm dropping in the next few days. Like this video and share this particular video with a friend or also on your social media platform so that most of your friends can be able to learn more about the African culture, specifically the Kenyan culture, and get a whole new experience in video production. Recently, I did a drone tour of Nairobi City, and I'd really appreciate if you watched that amazing video so that many people can see a different side of Africa that CNN or those big platforms have not told you about. This video is for you and it's somewhere here. And as you watch that one, I have amazing more content cooking up for you. So stay tuned and enjoy this particular video up next.